Good morning to all. Welcome back to 7th Standard Social online class. Students, today we are going to write second midterm exam. For second midterm exam, totally we have 3 lessons. First, we will see the social portion. History, first lesson. Geography, first lesson. And civics also, first lesson. So, totally 3 lessons for our revision. And now we will see the question pattern. Choose 5 marks, fill in the blanks 5 marks, match the following 5 marks, 2 are false, 4 marks, answer the following questions, 5 you have to write, each carry 2 marks, so 10 marks, and distinguish between 2 you have to write 4 marks, give reason, 1 you have to write carry 2 marks. And regarding paragraph or detail, you have to write 3 questions. So, totally 15 marks. You see here, choose 5 more, fill in the blanks 5 marks. Match it 5 marks, true or false 4 marks. Short answer 10 marks, distinguish 4 marks, give reason 2 marks. And detail 15 marks, totally 50 marks you are going to write. Already we have revised the first lesson in history. Today we will revise second lesson and geography first lesson and civics first lesson for revise. Now we are going to revise geography unit number 1 resources. First we will see the choose the correct answer. Which one of the following is renewable resource? The answer is solar energy. So solar energy is the renewable resources. Where is the largest solar power project situated in India? Kamudi. You underline the glue word in question. Largest solar power project is Kamudi. Which is one of the first metal known and used by man? Copper. The answer is copper is the first metal known and used by man. Das is one of the indispensable mineral used in electrical and electronic industry. That is mica. Mica is one of the indispensable mineral used in electrical industry. Electricity produced from coal is called thermal power. Electricity produced from coal is called thermal power. See the answer correctly. And come to the fill in the blanks. Das is the largest producer of hydroelectricity, China. The answer is China. Iron ores found at Kanchamalai. Know the word Kanchamalai in Tamil Nadu. Das is produced from bauxite ore. Aluminium is produced from bauxite ore. Aluminium is produced from bauxite ore. Das is used in making electrical batteries, manganese. Petroleum and its derivatives are called black gold. See the answer correctly, write the spelling correctly. Then come to the match the following. Renewable resource, the answer is wind energy. Metallic resource, iron. Non-metallic resource, mica. Fossil fuel, you see here, fossil fuel, petroleum, limestone, sedimentary rock. You see the answer. Renewable resource, wind energy. Metallic resource, iron. Non-metallic resource, mica. Fossil fuel, petroleum, limestone, sedimentary rock. Mark the answer correctly. Now consider the following statement and tick the appropriate answer. Wind power is clean energy is correct. Wind turbine do not produce any emission. So here answer is A. A and R are correct and R explain A. A and R are correct, R explain A. Both A and R are correct. And R is the correct reason for A. Natural gas is found in petroleum deposit. It can be used as a domestic and industrial fuel. So here also A and R are correct. Or explain A. You mark the answer A for both the question. Now we will move to answer the following. First question, define resource. Anything which can be used for satisfying the human needs is called resource. Anything which can be used for satisfying the human needs is called resource. Second question, what are the uses of iron? Iron is used to manufacture steel. So iron is mainly used to make steel and also used in civil engineering like reinforced concrete, girders, etc. So iron also used in engineering work like making concrete and girders like that. It is used to make alloyed steels like carbon steels with additives such as nickel, chromium, vanadium, tungsten and manganese. So these are the uses of iron. What are the major utilizers of solar energy in the world? Which countries major they used solar energy majorly? India, China, Japan, Italy and States of America. They are the major user of solar energy. Which countries they use solar energy highly? The major user, utilizer mean user of solar energy are India, Japan, China, Italy and States of America. These are the five countries. Name the types of coal based on carbon content. Coal is classified into four types based on carbon content. So based on the quality of carbon, based on the carbon content, we can divide the coal into four types. Anthracite, bituminous, lignite, pyrite. Again, I'm telling anthracite, bituminous, lignite and pyrite. Give a short note on duralumin. Duralumin is an alloy. So duralumin is an alloy, a trade name given to earliest types of age hardenable aluminium alloys. So it is an aluminium alloy. It is an alloy made up of 90% aluminium. So it is the alloy made up of 90% aluminium, 4% copper, 1% magnesium and 0.5% to 1% manganese. So duralumin is a hard but a lightweight alloy of aluminium. So duralumin is a metal, it's aluminium metal, highly qualified aluminium. It is hard but a lightweight alloy of aluminium. Students, study this question. It's very easy to study this one. 2 marks. Now we will see biotic resources and abiotic resources. Biotic, living organism. Abiotic, non-living organism. This is the main difference. So biotic resources are found in the biosphere which are obtained, which are received from living and organic material. Abiotic resources are received from non-living parts of an environment. Biotic resources is depend on abiotic resources for their survival. So all biotic resources, all living organisms, they mainly depend on non-living things for their survival. Abiotic resources do not depend on biotic resources for their survival. Example for biotic, plants, trees, animals, microorganisms, etc. Example for abiotic, sunlight, temperature, water, soil, air, etc. See these questions. Now, renewable and non-renewable. Renewable means we can reproduce again and again. Non-renewable means once we use, we cannot reproduce again. We will see the answer. Renewable resources. It can be used again and again throughout its life. Non-renewable resources cannot be used again and again as it is limited, which can be depleted one day. Renewable resources are present in unlimited quantity. Renewable resources are unlimited, but non-renewable resources are present in a limited quantity only. These resources are pollution-free. Renewable resources are, they do not make any pollution. But non-renewable resources are not pollution-free. They are making pollution to the environment. Example for renewable, solar energy, wind energy and hydropower. Example for non-renewable, fossil fuel, iron, copper, gold, silver, etc. The third question, metallic resources. Metallic resources are the types of resources that are composed of metal. The resources is composed of purely metal. Non-metallic resources can be described as the resources, but they do not comprise of metal. These are hard substances. Metallic resources are very hard, which are the good conductor of heat and electricity. But non-metallic resources are not hard substances and also they are not good conductor of heat and electricity. Example for metallic, iron, copper, gold, bauxite, silver, manganese, etc. These are the example for metallic resources. Non-metallic resources, mica, limestone, gypsum, dolomite, phosphate, etc. And give reason, aluminium has wide range of uses compared to other metals. Aluminium is a light in weight, tough and cheaper. It makes it popular metal for constructional purpose. It is mainly used in construction of aircraft, that is aeroplane, ship, automobile, railway coaches, etc. So aluminium has a wide range of use compared to other metal. Water is considered as a great source of energy. At present, water is used for producing hydroelectric power. So we are use water for producing electricity. Hydroelectricity is generated, is produced from moving water with high speed and high velocity and great falls with the help of turbine and dynamo. So water is considered as a great source of energy. Students, see this distinction between, among these three distinctions between, two will come. And among two give reasons, one will come. There is no choices for distinction between and give reason. And see the paragraph. In history, there is only one paragraph, achievements and careers of Vijayanagar Empire. Surely it will come. Krishnadevaraya. In geography, there are three paragraphs are there. Two paragraphs will come for exam. You see the first paragraph, that is very important. Explain the different types of renewable resources and study third detail. What are the different types of fossil fuel resources? Explain them. So among these three paragraph, two will come. I will give the important question also. Study well. Now we will see civics lesson 1, state government. Choose the correct answer. What is the minimum age for becoming a member of state legislative council? 30 years. State legislative council, 30 years. How many states does India have? 29 states. The word state government referred to government department in the state legislative assembly. Both A and B answer. Both A and B are correct. The overall head of the government in the state is prime minister. Who appoints the chief minister and other minister? Answer is governor. Who became the chief minister? Leader of the majority party. Leader of the majority party became the chief minister. What are the three branches of the state government? Legislative, executive and judiciary. Legislative, executive and judiciary. Now we will move to the fill in the blanks. The governor is appointed by President of India. The leader of the majority party, already it has come for choose the chief minister. The leader of the majority party is appointed as a chief minister in the state assembly. That's the highest judicial organ of the state, the High Court. High Court is the highest judicial organ. MLA stands for Member of Legislative Assembly. MLA means Member of Legislative Assembly. Das is a particular area from where all the voters living there choose their representative electoral constituencies. Electoral constituencies. The elector representatives who are not the member of ruling party are called opposition party. Now match the following. MLA, Legislative Assembly. Governor, head of the state. Chief Minister, leader of the majority party. Union Territories, how many Union Territories? 7. Fort St. George Secretariat. Consider the following statement. Which of the following statement is not correct? Here the answer is B. Fourth, he should have completed 25 years of age is not a correct one. So B is not a correct one. So answer is 4. Roman letter 4. Consider the following statement and state true or false. MLAs are together responsible for working of the government. Answer is 2. All the MLAs of other political party who do not belong to the ruling party are called opposition. True. MLAs are not the representative of the people. False. Find out the correct meaning of bicameral legislature. It means that there are two houses like upper house and lower house. The answer is C. You see here, yes, answer is C. India has a federal system of government. Correct. According to our constitution, the power is divided between central and state government. That also correct. So A is correct or explain A. Answer is A. Now you see that 2 mark question. What are the qualifications to become a governor of state? Important 2 mark question. Because it will come for 10th also. What are the qualifications need to become a governor of state? A person to be eligible to the post of governor should be a citizen of India. He should have completed 35 years of age. He should have sound mind and should not hold any public office or profit. So he must be citizen of India. He must have the age, 35 years of age. He should have a sound mind of knowledge and he should not hold any public office. Who are called opposition? All the MLAs of other political parties who do not belong to the ruling party are called opposition. So the MLAs of other political parties, those are not belonging to ruling party, they are called opposition party. Write a note on Lok Adalat. This is a important question. So Lok Adalat is a people court. It will come for 10th also. It also have been established by the government of India. So Lok means people, Adalat means court. So Lok Adalat means people court. It was established by government of India. To settle dispute through conciliation and compromise, Lok Adalat have been given statutory status under the Legal Service Authority Act of 1987. What is a constituency is also important question. Political parties nominate their candidate to each constituency. All the people residing in that constituency who has completed the age of 18 cast their vote. So constituency means the people living area. Political parties nominate their candidate to each constituency. Who appoint the chief minister and other ministers? The chief minister is appointed by governor, who also appoint other ministers on the advice of chief minister. The council of ministers is collectively responsible to legislative assembly of the state. You see here, total 5 questions are here. Among these 5 questions, 3 questions will come for exam. You see the first question is very important. And Lok Adalat constituency, these are the important questions in this lesson. Describe the powers of the governor is very, very important questions. You see this one. Totally 3 questions, 1 questions will come for exam. Study the questions carefully. Students, we have finished our revision for our exam. You study all the lessons carefully. Study all the book back with 1 word and 2 marks and detail. An important detail also I have mentioned here. You study thoroughly and write well. All the best.